Hi, I'm Philipp Erler from the TU Wien. I present Points2Surf, our new surface reconstruction method. Our method solves the following problem. We have an unordered point cloud with noise like the one on the left, and we want to reconstruct the original surface. The gold standard Screened Poisson Surface Reconstruction fits a signed distance field to a given point cloud. It has no learned prior, which makes it very general but limits its robustness and accuracy. One recent data-driven method is AtlasNet, which aligns the vertices of subdivided planes to a point cloud. Another one is DeepSDF, which learns an SDF from a point cloud. Both have a global shape prior, which doesn't generalize well. Our method, on the other hand, learns a local shape prior that improves robustness and accuracy without losing generalization performance. Our neural network predicts a signed distance from a query point, here in red, to a surface that is sampled with noise, here in gray. We use two subsamples. The local prior can be learned from a local subsample and generalizes across shapes, shown in orange. This subsample consists of 300 nearest neighbors of the query point. A global subsample, shown in purple, is required for the inside-outside decision and only needs to be coarse. This subsample is over the entire point cloud with a distance-dependent probability. This is our architecture. We start with the two subsamples mentioned before. The upper one is the global and the lower one is the local subsample. We take the QSTN from PCPNet to normalize the orientation of the global subset. Then we apply the learned rotation on both subsamples. We use two point transformers from PCPNet to convert each rotated subset individually to feature vectors. We concatenate these feature vectors and put them in a multi-layer perceptron. This MLP outputs two floats, the sign and the absolute distance. The reason for the split is that we can turn the inside-outside prediction into a classification, which is easier to learn than a regression. In the end, we multiply the floats and get the sign distance. Here you can see some examples from the ABC dataset. The ABC dataset consists of 1 million cat objects, from which we take around 5,000 for our training set and 100 for our test set. We use the time-of-flight scanner from Blensor to sample the point clouds with realistic artifacts like scan shadows and noise. We vary the noise strength randomly between zero noise, like on the left, and strong noise, like on the right. Additionally, we take a random number of scans between 5 and 30 from random positions. Here are some examples from our test set. It consists of 22 well-known objects like the Stanford Bunny and the Armadillo. We made 5 variants of this dataset. No noise, medium noise, strong noise, sparse, and dense. Let's have a look at some qualitative results. The first row is an object from the ABC dataset, the second row is from the famous dataset, and the third row is from the Fingy 10K dataset with similar properties as the famous dataset. You can see that our method performs much better on cavities and fine details. The downside is that Points2Surf produces topological noise in some cases and takes longer to compute. Here are more results from the ABC dataset. And even more ABC examples from our supplementary material. These are examples from the famous dataset. And these are from the Thingy 10K dataset as shown in the supplementary material. Let's now compare Poisson reconstruction with our method in detail. SPR closes the holes and produces a bumpy surface. Points2Surf can even reconstruct the small holes but produces some topological noise. With strong noise, SPR bloats small features and fills even large gaps. Again, Points2Surf is more accurate but produces topological noise. As mentioned before, SPR needs oriented point normals, which we estimate with PCPNet. In certain areas, like the center of this heart shape, it is difficult to get the right orientation. Failure can lead to such artifacts. Points2Surf doesn't need normals and is therefore immune to this problem. Here you can see an extract from our quantitative comparison. This table shows the average chamfer distance over the test set as absolutes and relative to Points2Surf. The first three rows are the ABC dataset without noise, with strong noise and the mean of both. The last three rows are the same for the famous dataset. A short reminder, DeepSDF and AtlasNet have a global prior, SPR has no learned prior, and our method uses a local prior. We trained all data-driven methods on the man-made objects of the ABC VAR noise variant and evaluated the generalization with organic objects. The error of DeepSDF and AtlasNet relative to our method increases when going from the training set to the test set. SPR, on the other hand, has a better relative result on the famous dataset. This shows that DeepSDF and AtlasNet have a worse generalization performance than our method. SPR has a very good generalization, but is overall less robust and accurate. Points2Surf solves these problems with a fine local and a coarse global prior. Now let's look at noise robustness. We have zero noise on the left and strong noise on the right. For DeepSDF and AtlasNet, the generalization issues overshadow the noise. SPR is accurate overall but fills in the large hole. Our method is able to reconstruct that hole and even the small ones. With strong noise, SPR gets bumpy, while Points2Surf tends to produce some topological noise. Here are two examples of real-world point clouds. The upper one is made with structure from motion, and the lower one is from a multi-view dataset. You can again see that DeepSDF and AtlasNet don't generalize well. Poisson reconstruction is pretty good, but loses some details, like the sticks of the torches. To summarize, Points2Surf uses a strong local prior that combines robustness and accuracy with good generalization. This makes it a good solution for all kinds of point clouds, independent from object classes and acquisition methods. It is especially strong in cavities and in fine details. On top, it doesn't require point normals. The source code models and datasets are available on GitHub. We hope to see you at the Q&A sessions.